3D printed speakers. We've done part one. We've done part two. This is not part three, but we have to get through this to get to part three. And to get through this, we got a lot to go through because I'm gonna talk about this machine and the prints that it's doing. So, yeah, baby, let's do it. Hey there, welcome back. Yes, this is a really, really big bender, 200% scale in fact. Before we talk about this though, and this machine right here, I'm gonna talk about some prints from it. I'm gonna give you kind of the process that I've gone through in order to make the prints the best they can be. We're gonna talk about this tiny speaker, and then we're gonna talk about the last printed piece of the puzzle for the 3D printed speakers. I think that's fun. Before we do that though, here is my view. This is my office, and it's I've got a light balanced on my CR30 so you can see me. It's amazing. So what is this machine? This is the Project R3D Daedalus. And I know on stream we talked about different ways, whether it was Daedalus or Daedalus, or it's the Daedalus. It is a large format Core XY fully built 3D printer that I believe is 300 by 300 by 345. I think those are the dimensions. I bought this because I wanted a large Core XY machine. I didn't want to have to build it myself yet. Don't worry, I've got plans to build one myself. And I wanted to support a good person and a good company. Joe at Project R3D, he's been a really good supporter of the channel. I would consider him to be a good dude. But also, he's building something really awesome here. When I bought this, I talked about it. I told him some of the issues I had, and he's putting together documentation. But what's great is when I got this out of the box on that stream, he said any of the ones that were purchased during the stream, he would give $300 to Seattle Children's Hospital. So I ended up buying one, so they got a $300 donation, which is incredible. Plus, when I did that really big, massive giveaway, he donated one of these as a prize. It's awesome. So this is a machine I bought. All opinions are my own. And I can tell you right now, it's been a good machine to play with. And if you're ever interested, there's a link in the description. You can go to Project R3D and check it out yourself. So before the tiny speaker, before the big bender, I started with this. It's a bowl, and it's got some issues. It's stringy. The layers are inconsistent. This was one of the first prints I did with the machine, and I used default settings. It was sliced in Prusa Slicer, and it was printing way, way, way too fast. I printed this in Prusa Slicer using the defaults, which were really, really fast. And while it can produce prints at that speed, the problem is you still have to tune it for each material. And so it looks like this. It can still hold stuff. Obviously it's got holes in it, so it's not gonna hold water, but it's a dish, and I put my keys and my bits in it from 3D printing, and it's been useful. So even though it's not perfect, I did wanna show off that not every print off this machine comes perfect, and you do have to take your time. And so this, as being a first print, while it doesn't look perfect, it still serves a purpose, and I'm really glad I still have it. It's Prusa Slicer in Atomic Dark Cherry Red, and it's 0.15 millimeter layer height. It's 209C on the nozzle and 60C on the bed. So why don't we talk about this big bender right here? I am a huge Futurama fan, and Bender is one of my favorite characters.
Shut up, baby, I know it.
I met the voice actor for Bender, John DiMaggio, and he's a legit good dude, but he did the voice for me when I met him. So that was a lot of fun. But this is in Atomic PLA, Deep Black PLA, Deep Black. Prusa Slicer was the slicer for this, 0.15 millimeter layer height, 200% scale, 215C on the nozzle and 60C on the bed. And it came out beautiful. One of the things that I want to show you is that it is consistent right here from the feet and the legs, but also have a look at the pattern. So this fur coat that Bender is wearing just has this texture to it, and it feels amazing. It's incredible. Like, I'll do my best to try to convey what it's like, but I mean, at the same time, if you have a 3D printer, printing something with this texture will just blow your mind, because it doesn't feel like a printed piece at that point. I really, really love this model, and
200% scale seemed to be perfect. It makes sense. Some of the other models from this creator for Futurama, they just look weird in 3D. Bender seemed to look okay, and so that's why I printed them out. I sent this out on Twitter. This is a Mythic mug, and this is printed in the Strong Hero 3D Metal X Sparkling. This was sliced in Prusa Slicer. It's 0.15 millimeter layer height. It's 209C on the nozzle and 60C on the bed. And this was using slightly modified defaults. I slowed the print speed down just slightly for this, but for this to come out this good, especially with how little configuration I had to do, it really blows my mind. It's not that it's an incredibly tough model to print, but for it to look exceptionally good, you have to have very consistent extrusion all the way through. Plus, right here, this part right here, it looks great. It's that perfect angle of geometry that allows the printer to print it and not have to suffer from any problems with an overhang. Oh, it's a beautiful model. I mean, even look at the bottom. This is when I use the PEI sheet. Bottom looks good too. But for this, it's incredible. It'll hold a can of Coke or something like that. I'm really, really happy with the way it turned out. Like this is one of those things. I thought about printing it out and putting some gold on it or spraying it with a metallic or something like that. But I love the look of this filament and the way that the colors sort of broke right here. And I'm just really, I'm really, really happy with this print. Next, I tried some vase mode prints. And this is a modern take on the Christmas tree. I believe it was by Herblinks. This is Filament One Glint PLA. And this is some really, really old Polyalchemy Emerald City Elixir. So this was in spiral mode and I sliced this in Idea Maker. I created an Idea Maker profile for this machine because I wanted to see what this slicing engine could do, and it did a really good job. 0.2 millimeter layers, 209C on the nozzle, 60C on the bed. This one looks perfect. Like it's absolutely perfect. You pick it up, you look at it, you turn it around, and you're just looking at the perfection of a print. I'm really, really astonished at how good this looks, especially the tip. And so part of tuning that profile was to slow down the printer when the layers were small. So set it's like a minimal layer time. I think that helped with creating that point. And that point is just perfect, just perfect. This one, the material is old and it's interesting. Polyalchemy Elixir material is just really interesting to print with. So I don't have terribly good layer bonding with this material. And when trying to get it off the build plate, it kind of split right there. And that's no good. You also see some inconsistencies kind of right under here where the model is. And I mean, it's okay. As far as a Christmas decoration goes, it's wonderful. It's a green tree, so it worked just fine. But going by the technicality of the print, it's not as good as this one. And it could be because the material is older. It could also be because this requires different settings, which I don't think it does. But anyway, I have trees. One of the things I do want to talk about are the upgrades that have been done to this machine. One is that it had a PEI over aluminum for a bed. This now has a magnetic bed, so it is flexible. And it was flexible, and I was using it was flexible steel with PEI on top. Kind of looked like this. But then Wham Bam sent over one of these. This is a powder-coated PEI sheet, and I've been running this ever since. This has really good adhesion, and so I just kind of slap it in, make sure it's aligned, and I'm good to go. The other upgrade that happened was the blower and the fan shroud. So originally, this is what the machine came with, and it's okay.
Soka.
It's okay, but it's a single fan mounted to this side, and it's trying to get air around to most sides of the nozzle. It can't do it as effectively as other systems do. And to be honest, with a machine like this, you're built to print pretty quick. So you have to have incredibly optimal cooling in order to lay down that filament and cool it off once it's laid down. This wasn't doing the trick. And it's evident in that clock spring dice dozer model that I showed off not so long ago. It's also evident in these. And so I now have an upgraded one. Project R3D, and they're sending this to every Daedalus owner. Project R3D now has a dual fan design for the shroud, and it's incredible. The way that it models the air under the nozzle, it's perfectly pinpointed. It's almost like a tornado under there. It's hard to visualize. I mean, I can show it to you and it looks cool, but you know, the proof is in the pudding, right? So what I did is, this is one that I initially printed. This is one that was printed with this fan shroud, and this is atomic filament. It's 0.15 millimeters. It's, you know, 215C on the nozzle, 60C on the bed. It's two perimeters, 10% infill. It's just defaults, right? But you do see some issues along the sword and along the hilt and underneath the elbow right there. The problem is the machine, when printing this, has to be slowed down considerably or have enough air blowing on it in order to cool down that filament. So what I did is I ran the same G-code after swapping out the fan shroud and adding that second fan, and sure enough, it is better. It's not perfect by any means, because again, if I wanted to print this perfect, I would have to slow down the print just a little bit, just for some of the minor things. But if you look, the sword is better. It's not nearly as bad on the hilt, and the elbow looks pretty fantastic. So I know that I have a better functioning machine now, which means I could do some really cool stuff. I remember sending this out on Twitter, and these are calibration cubes, nothing really exciting, but to be honest, I was trying to get X, Y, and Z dimensionality correct, and these were close, but adjusting the filament extrusion multiplier, I was able to get these down to 20 millimeters across X, Y, and Z. And I measured that and I showed it on Twitter. And yes, that my calipers that I have here only go down to tenths and they don't go down to hundredths. But at the same time, that's pretty good. If I'm accurate to within tenths for a 3D print, I'm pretty excited about that. And so I keep these around just to remind me of what I was able to do. I think it's time we talk about this. So the 3D printed speaker project is something that I've been trying to get done. And so far you've seen these pieces. We've seen the bottom piece. The first one was printed on the big printer in the garage. And then the second one on the G-Max 2. These pieces right here, these were both printed on the CraftBot Flow IDEX XLs at the studio. And this piece, the face, was printed on the big printer in the garage. The last piece of the puzzle is this thing. This is the cap, and the cap rests up here and kind of holds everything together. I believe it'll, there we go. So there's this piece. The cap holds the top of the face on, and it's so tiny, I might have to drill holes kind of set. There we go. So it just kind of holds it together like that. So the last piece of the puzzle was the cap. And so what I did, I used some filament one, and it's their glint PLA, and it is green, and I printed the caps. These are at 0.15 millimeters. These were sliced in Prusa slicer, and these are 215C on the nozzle, 60C on the bed. I actually used defaults for the speed because it wasn't complex geometry, but I want you to take a look at these. Look at that surface finish. These look fantastic. The bottoms, this was bridging. This right here is bridging, and it did a good job with it. So I'm really, really happy with it. And with these pieces, it means that everything that needs to be 3D printed is done for the really big speaker project that we're 3D printing. So next, it's to get all the electronics together and get the drivers installed, hook it up to a sound system, and hopefully play from sweet, sweet music. Oh, and one more thing. I've been teasing something on Twitter. I can almost fit the whole thing in the frame. Almost, let's see. So this was printed on the CR30. No, not the Daedalus. This was printed on the CR30, and it's part of
a large light holder. This is like 600 or 700% scale. You know, it's large. But one of the things that I talked about was being able to take the support off while I was actually printing. Let's see if I can't get some of it off here. So I'll get the rest of the support out another time, because what I want to show you is this. This was printed on my Daedalus, and this is a cap. It's not the best. There are some problems. I printed this at 0.3 millimeter layer height, and I hadn't really configured that. I hadn't really got that going as well. It's got some bumps where it does layer changes. So I think I need to play with my retraction settings a little bit. But these threads are supposed to match up with this, and so why don't we see if it works? Yeah! Now I just have to print another one of these and another one of these, but it looks like I will have a way of holding up a light in a really, really cool way. This is exciting. Well, listen, if you made it this far, you're awesome. I really appreciate it. I'm excited about what I've printed on this thing. And if you have any suggestions for other prints to use, obviously, leave those in the comments down below. Don't forget to hug each other more, be aggressively kind, and as always, high five.